Hello, my friends. It's Nancy Bastien. I'm not sure, but I think this might be one of my last videos before I move. And I still have a ton of stuff to do, and I just don't have the energy to do it. So my son said, Mom, just calm down. You know that me and my brother are going to be there for a week, and we'll help pack up your stuff. But anyway, I've been making some more of these little books. Like, I made this one, you know. Well, I haven't made any more, but I had some boxes. So I thought I'd make some more of these little books. And one of my viewers was disappointed last time because I went off camera when I sewed in the signatures. And she doesn't know how to sew signatures in, so she was a little disappointed. So I thought, well, I will make some more and sew the signatures in on camera, maybe. Last time I was all shaky, but I'll see how it goes. And I really want to have this horse up here on the front of my cover, but it just... Well, maybe if I cut it that way, I can get it on there. So, let's do it this way. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw around my little book here. And hopefully I can see where I'm drawing. So I can cut it out. Yeah. And then I have this one. My little sprocket came in this one. And it's kind of cute, so I don't know. We'll see what this one turns out. So I'm going to cut it on the outside of the line. I think this is in my way, this little cord here. Maybe that'll work. Hopefully I'm in shot in the camera so you can see what I'm doing here. So I've drawn on here. And I can't really see my line. So I'm going to go back on here and draw it a little darker. Cut on the outside of the line. Okie dokie, let's see what we got here. Oh yeah, that'll work. I cut it way too big though. How did I do that? Because there was my line right there. Well, I'll just trim it off. Okay. So, now what I'm going to do is I really didn't get that horse where I wanted it. But I'm going to bend my paper on the spine and get it trained to bend so it won't crack. And I'm going to go back this way and bend it and back this way and bend it, and then bend it again this way. Just need to keep doing that back and forth so your paper doesn't crack. And I'm upset because I didn't get that horsey where I wanted it. And now I should have left it a little bit bigger than my book, my paper. Because when I bend it, that's all right, I'll just cut my book off a little shorter. That'll work. All right, for the inside, I don't care, so I'm gonna just see if I can get it out of this end of the paper. For the inside. And I'm not having any go over, so I just kind of want it up to the edge. But I should cut it just a smidgen bigger, huh? Because of my fold. Okay. I'll come over here and cut it that much bigger for the inside. Because of my fold, I can always trim it off. I didn't, because of my spine. And I packed away all my good scissors that cut. And I'm not gonna go try to find them. I think they're in my sewing. I think I put them in my sewing machine that doesn't work. And I ordered one and it came and I hated it, so I sent it back. So much for me making any masks. Okay, so I'm doing the same thing. I'm folding it back, and folding it back, and folding it this way and this way. Now I'm having trouble with this little one here. I did this one earlier. And this card, this piece of paper I put on the inside was real heavy cardstock. And it's just having a hard time adhering to my book. So, now, I don't want to use this. Well, let's see. Well, that's just perfect. I want to see where that. But I wanted it like that, so. It'll be upside down on my front of my page unless. But I don't have enough. My book's too big. Well, maybe not. Yeah, it'll be upside down. I wanted it that way. So let's find a different piece of paper. I have one right over here. We'll use this one. Is that Christmas? Is this Christmas paper? Does that look like Christmas? This is Victoria's balloon. That must be a balloon. think it must be go this way, and it's a hot air balloon. Yep, that's what that is. All right, let's trim off the end of this. I'm not going to get to do the pages today, I don't think. Maybe later on, because I got to find paper for the pages and figure out how many signatures I'm going to... Oh, that didn't even cut. I think I need a new blade. Sometimes when these won't cut, it's because the inside of this is needs to be cleaned out. Is that just strange or what? And let me get my other cutter. Now I just tore that paper. Dang it. How can I just sit there and tear that paper like that? Well, maybe it won't. Maybe it'll be okay when I glue it down. Man, I need to pay more attention to what I'm doing here. I got too much stuff on my desk. Alright. Let's get this paper cut. And I didn't put it out far enough. Let's try this again. Okay. Alright, so this is a hot air balloon, I guess. So it needs to go like this. But that isn't going to get it on the front of my page. So, I'm not going to use that paper. I'm going to see if I can get it out of this. I have two of the same papers, but that's okay. That's A-okay. So, let's go for it. So I'm cutting on the outside of my line sorta, if I could cut straight. Okay, that one will go on here. Like that. Something like that. And that face is going to be upside down, but that's okay. Let's see if we can get the inside out of this. And we can for sure. And so I got two little books out of one piece of paper. Out of one 12 by 12 piece of paper. That's not bad. I was just going to take these to the thrift store, so I decided I'd make these little books out of it. The thrift store is not open because we're on lockdown, but you can put your donations on the outside of the door, and when they come to work on the inside, then they will take them on the inside. I'm going to take a drink of my tea. See? All right, let's get to gluing. Let's get to making some books here. So let's do this one first. So, that's what she said. I think I need to sand this a little bit so it will stick to it. Now I saw my sanding block. Hang on, I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere, guys. I just found my little sanding block the other day, so yay for me. I hadn't packed it away yet, so I'm going to sand this off a little bit. While I'm at it, I'm going to sand this one off a little bit because they're shiny and the paper doesn't want to stick to shiny stuff. And I think that's why I'm having a problem with this one on the inside, because I didn't sand it. Plus it's a thicker piece of paper. So let's get that wiped off. Yeah, sand it a little bit down here on this corner. I have to be frugal with my wet wipes, you know, because you can't get them. However, I went to Target the other day and they had flushable wipes, but they were limited, two to a customer. So I bought two. No, it was one to a customer. And yesterday I went to Big Lots because I needed to get some more bins for packing. And I went down their aisle. I got a few things there. Went down the aisle and they had no toilet paper, but they had flushable wipes. So they were limited to two. So I bought two of those. So hopefully, I hope these people are hoarding toilet paper that have a year's supply, will be kind enough to give people who didn't go out and hoard it to share. I think that's only appropriate. That we all should share at this time. But, you know, people don't want to share, and it's going to get worse before it gets better, I heard. And the warehouses are all empty and they can't keep up. That's why you don't see any more on the shelf. And this is just, if I'd have known that they were going to for toilet paper, I would have bought a few more packages. But I think I'll be okay till I get to Utah and get to my son's house. And he bought quite a bit of toilet paper at Costco. So he bought great big. He didn't buy a whole bunch, but he bought great big packages. They had big packages, you know. I think, I don't know how many he said he had was in the package, but he has a lot of toilet paper. All right, let's glue. Let's get this all cleaned off and let's glue. I have to wear this glove because I have tendonitis, and when I squeeze things like glue bottles, it really hurts my hand. So I'm going to use this 450 quick drying adhesive. I'm going to get it out to the edges I think this has silicone in it. Oh, see, it hurts my hand to squeeze. And it's not carpal tunnel, it is tendonitis, and there's not anything they can do for it. Other than wear my glove and when it hurts and puts tension on, or you know, it's a pressure, and that seems to help. All right, let's get this piece of paper on here. Let's see. I have a hard time gluing, guys. Getting things on there straight. Now I can trim off. That glued down really good. Maybe. There's two places that it just doesn't want to stick. And that piece I tore that made me mad. But I do have another sheet of this paper. Okay. Bend my pages. I think it's going to be okay. I think it's going to glue down nicely. And I'm going to give it a minute. Well, let's give it a minute and let's glue this one. Because I want, you know, need to trim it off. So, let's get this one glued. I like these little miniature books. I don't know. I'm just probably going to glue in them, you know. I don't know. But they're fun, and I did get my son's pictures, all the pictures in the little picture book that I made. And it looked, I didn't decorate it, I just left it like it was. It just was too hard to get washi tape and stuff around those pictures. So I'm going to order, not now, but when I get to Utah, I'm going to order some of that paper that, has, you can get paper that has, man, oh man, this is not straight. This is not cut straight. That has a border around it. So, there. Except for I should have spread my glue out a little better because it's kind of lumpy. I hate lumpy glue. Clumpy glue, lumpy glue, clumpy, clumpy, lumpy. Okay, guys, we had, the other day, we had 80 degree weather one day. Well, it was really high. This didn't get on there straight. Of course. And you know, here I thought summer was here, and then we had tornadoes that night, and you know, we had to take cover in the basement. Luckily I had a basement. Luckily there's not tornadoes in Utah. Because where I'm going to move doesn't have a basement, but Utah, well, anyway. So, Yeah, we had tornadoes that night. And then the next day, that was night before last is when, day before yesterday was when it was so hot. And then that night, night before last is when we had tornado warnings and a real bad storm and yada yada. And then the next day, it turned off cold. Yesterday was really cold. Today it's cold and we have snow in the forecast. I can't believe it. This crazy, crazy world we live in with an epidemic, and you can't say that word on YouTube or they won't let you monetize your... Is that stupid? Well, that looks pretty cool, doesn't it? However, I wish it was this way. Oh, well. Let's see about the horsey one. Oh, we got the back end on the... We just got the back end on the front. But we got this. Alright, well, I have to be... Get what I get, because I didn't cut it right. Well, I cut it the best I could for this piece of paper here. And I'm going to have to cut a little bit off of my book, because it's not matching up. I'm gonna leave it. It's not that bad. It's not perfect, but who's perfect, right? Not me. My things are not perfect because I don't want them to be. Alright. Now, years ago when I was a scrapbooker, I probably would have pitched this in the garbage because it just wasn't perfect, because the I'm just trimming this up because the butt of the horse is in the front, and I would have just pitched it in the garbage because the unicorn is on the spine of the book. How silly. I could have moved it over, I guess. Oh well. So much for that. Let's get this trimmed up better. Every time I look at it, it's crooked. Crooked, crooked. Okay, let's get the inside glued in. Now, I want this. I don't want the stripes, but I don't, want these pencil marks, so I'm going to try to erase them. Let's get to gluing. Oh my goodness. Okay. Come on, glue, don't make me squeeze so hard. Why is it doing this? Just because it knows that I have a sore hand. So I hope everybody's doing okay with this. I see that there's a lot of my YouTubers that I watch that are doing okay. They're not, I haven't heard of anybody getting ill on this on YouTube. I could be wrong, but people I watch mostly are doing okay with being on lockdown. You know, I don't go anywhere anyway because, you know, I'm just here by myself and I don't go anywhere except for, you know. So it's really not bothering me other than things are closed. Some of the stores are closed that I would normally go to, like the craft stores are all closed. And Joann's, you can order online or an order from the store and they will come curbside to bring you. And so will Michael's. I ordered some scissors from Michael's. And they came out to my car and brought them to me. I'm trying to get this on here, even Steven. See how that works. That's why I like to cut it a little bit bigger. Because sometimes I'm not even. And I want to get it in these folds really good. So I'm using my bone folder to push this down. I wish I could find my big one. I have a big one like this, and then I have a flat one that you just hold in your hand. I really like that one. And I think I located it downstairs, but I don't know what I did with it. All right, let's see. Okay, that looks good. That looks really okay. A-okay. So let's trim. And then we'll glue the other one. And then I'm going to go and find pages. And figure out how many signatures I'm going to need in each one of these little ones. This one had a really big spine. These don't. So probably only going to put maybe one big signature in it instead of several. We'll see. So I'm going to trim this up. And then I'm going to... I wish I'd have gotten some blue ink out. I think this needs to be edged in blue ink. And I'm going to have to go find some. Okay. So my book is a little showing right there. And it's crooked, but that's all right. Crooked, crooked, crooked. Now let's see. That still did not glue in the spine, and that's not nice that it won't stick in the spine area. And then we're gonna push it down and see if it will adhere. Okay, I think that's going to be good enough. We have a horse's butt on the front of our, a horse's behinder on the front of our book. And the head is on the spine. Okay, that one is glued as good as it's going to get, I guess. I don't know why it won't Every time I bend it, it comes apart. Maybe I shouldn't bend it. That sounded like thunder. Am I jiggling? Is it, when I do that, is the camera jiggling? Oh, that will drive people crazy in my video. I'm gonna have to move the camera off of the table. The camera leg. Dang it! Now see, that won't glue. It buckles. I don't know how to stop that from doing that. Unless I just leave it flat and then bend it after it's glued on, but then I'm afraid it's gonna crack. I'm just gonna leave it alone. Okay, let's do this one. And then I'm gonna go find some blue ink. Now, should I do that stripe it on this one? Let's do it stripe it. Let's be different. Okay, let's do the stripes. Let's do this glue again. I'm gonna put some, come on, glue. Get to the, okay, don't move. Don't move. Don't move, book. Don't move. Okay, you don't need to move. You can stay right there. I'm gonna put some glue right in the spine and that folding area. I put glue there before, but okay, we got glue out to the ends, out to the ends. Put a lot of glue in here. And in here, and around, and around, and around we go over here. And we want to spread that out a little bit, but I don't want to put my finger in it because I can't stand that. And I'm going to spread this out a little bit. To the end, to the edges. Some glue in here. This glue is really gonna give me a headache if I keep using it. Woo! It's like sniffing glue, man. Sniffing glue. Alright, let's get this piece of paper on here, okay? Everybody see what I'm doing? Seems to be adhering until I bend it, and then it will come apart, and that drives me absolutely crazy. I'm gonna roll it. And get it adhered. Okay, now I'm going to try and bend it. Slowly, slowly, slowly. And I'm going to trim it. I have to hold my mouth a certain way while I'm doing this. You've heard that joke. People, when I was younger, I wanted so desperately to get pregnant. And it just was not working. And I think it was my mom. She was joking with me and she said, "You just aren't holding your mouth right." And I was like, "Well, how are you supposed to do that?" And she started laughing at me. She said, "I wasn't holding my mouth right." Well, how do you hold your mouth right? Alright. Alright, let's see. See, it's still coming up. And I don't know how it's not gonna do that. Maybe I shouldn't put the paper on like that. Maybe I should only put the paper to here and then put something in the middle. I don't know. Well, I am not going to worry about it, but I am. I am worried about it. And I think this piece right here is my book. And it just needs to get trimmed off. Because it just wasn't matching. Alright, I'm going to put a little clamp on it. And see if it'll stick. Because I don't want to have a hole. I don't want to have it not glued there. You know what I mean, guys? I don't know what I mean, so how can you know what I mean? Alright, hang on, guys. I'll be back in a minute because I'm going to go find some blue distressed ink to edge my books with, because they need to be edged in ink. I'll be right back because I have to go look in the drawer, and you don't want me to be that long, so I'll be right back. Alright guys, I found some blue chip sapphire, and I think that's going to look the best on it, so we shall see. Here we go. Here we go. I didn't move the camera. Okay, so where am I? Right here. So we're just gonna ink around it, and that will cover up any boo-boos, anything that's sticking out that's not supposed to be there, you know. Yeah, so let's do the inside now. I'm gonna be like Pam on the Paper Outpost. She's the inking queen. She inks. And I really didn't realize how nice it looked until she started doing it. Now that looks really nice, doesn't it? With the ink on there. Alright, let's do the little one. My thumb is killing me from squeezing that glue. I'm gonna have to go put some, it's It's pain cream. It's not. I used to use aspirin cream on it that was like an aspirin, and that worked really well. But I have some other pain relieving cream, and it works really well. So I'm going to have to go get some and put it. It's not like icy hot or anything like that, but it's a cream like aspirin cream. And it really helps a lot. All right, I'm going to show you something what happened. So, I do believe it's better to let your things dry like this. Let them dry like this. Instead of folding them up to dry. And because, look at this. He wants to be in this position at all times, so I can't open it. And it's going to be really difficult. And see, you see that right there. Well, yeah. So, it's better to let them dry open like this, and then do your bending. But let's ink this one up. Now, let's see, we have Vintage Photo is the one I want for this. And I have a little brush over here. My little toothbrush thing, makeup brush, whatever. It works well. So we're gonna ink this up. Make it shine. So if you glue it bent in that position, then you're not gonna be able to get it out straight to mark for your signatures, and you know, I should have remembered that, but I didn't, because you know, I'm getting old and my memory's getting old, and it likes to forget stuff when you get old. Yeah, when you after you retire, you seem to forget things a lot more than when you were working and keeping your brain active. That's why you need to keep your brain active. My mother-in-law used to do crossword puzzles every day out of the paper and other word puzzles just to keep her mind, you know, and she was 92. She had just turned 93, I think, when she passed away. Her birthday was on the 17th of March, and she passed away on the 29th, just right after her birthday. Okay, so we have this little book. And 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 I'm going to go and I'm going to get papers for each one of these little books and figure out how many signatures. I'm probably going to have to do maybe 4 signatures like I did in this one. And possibly maybe 1 big signature in this one. And maybe 2. 2 in this one. Maybe 3. I don't know. But I wanted to show you the little book that has all the pictures in it that I made for my son. So, I got pictures here and here and here and here and here. I think you saw these pictures when I was making it. But now we have pictures here on these. And here on these. Is that cool? And here. He's gonna have fun with this book. And here. And then over here. And in here. And here is just a journal page. I didn't put a picture on that one because I stamped on it. So if he wants to, he can write on it or not, or just leave it like it is. I could put a picture over the top of it, I guess. Two more pictures. And it's okay like it is. So, yeah, we have these that go in the inserts now. Isn't that nice? All right, guys, I'm going to go now and get the pages and get them ready. And maybe I need to pack some boxes. I don't know. But anyway, I will be back in a little while, or maybe tomorrow. I don't know. So I will see you on the next video. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and share. And please subscribe. And please be my bell and ring the bell and be my bell. And you will get notifications from when my next video is coming. And all that good stuff. You know, all that good stuff. Oh, leave me comments, please. I love comments. And if you have questions about anything that I have been doing, please ask me and I will answer, or I'll get the answer as soon as I can. But remember that I'm busy right now trying to get moved. I don't have very many more days. I'm going to be out of here on the 30th. My furniture is going on the 25th. My sister-in-law bought my furniture, so she's going to get all that. And then my two sons come on the 26th, and we pick up the truck on the 28th, and we're out of here on the 30th. And in between that time, I've got to get stuff ready to go to the thrift store, stuff ready to go to the junk and to the recycle bin, and in my boxes to pack. And I will talk to you later. Thanks. Bye-bye, guys.